What I'm going to be doing in this video is kind of like a real-time clip art drawing. I did one of these before. I just don't want it to be a speed drawing, and basically from start to finish, I'm going to show one clip art drawing being made and also being uploaded on Teachers Pay Teachers and potentially also on Etsy. So as usual, I'm starting with an 8x8 inch 300 resolution canvas. And I think what I wanted to do is, I'm gonna do just like a freebie clip art because I haven't done it in a long time. So I wanted to do something fallish, but I'm thinking what I'm gonna do is like a kid at a laptop because it seems like there's a lot of laptops in schools these days. My brush is just one of the generic ones. Usually I have it tapered, which if you're not sure of how to do that, you do it over here, size jitter, you switch it to pen pressure. If you have it off, it won't taper, and I want it to taper. Opacity is at 10%. I'm getting a Snapchat from Justin. Let me check that. Can you hear my chair making noises? My chair's kind of squeaky. I'm sorry. It's just going to be like this. Maybe like this? Ooh, no, no, no. Okay, come on. Come on, Jesse. So now that we have the very rough pre-sketch, I'm going to add a new layer, maybe come in with a 20% brush and start to put in some sort of a face. Oh my God, my chair's driving me nuts. Ah, it's so squeaky. Okay, that head seems enormous. So let's just shrink it because it seems a little big. I mean, I always draw lollipop kids anyways, but we don't want them that lollipop-y. My last freebie was a girl, so I'm gonna make this one a boy, I guess. I've already decided. All right, so his shoulders are gonna be kind of down because he's reaching down. And I feel like I'm gonna need to move this whole bottom part closer because I feel like otherwise his arms are gonna be like crazy long and we don't want that. So scooch it over here, scooch that a little closer. All right, let's ponder what's going on down here. Good, get rid of his legs. If I sat in this position, I would only last about 5 minutes before I'd have to get out of it again. That was one of the first signs of aging for me, was I realized I couldn't sit in positions the way that I could before. Let's drop this opacity down to pretty much nothing. We'll drop this one down to about half. I'm gonna flip the canvas to make sure it doesn't look really weird. I don't think it does. I'm gonna take a sip of coffee, add a new layer. And now let's bring it up to 30% opacity up here. I don't usually do this many layers of sketches, but this is pretty sloppy, so I feel like I should, because otherwise I think it's just gonna be really hard for me with the black and white line art. He can wear a long sleeve because it's colder out now, so that's fine. We'll keep him in his long sleeve. Maybe we'll even put him in like a sweater. Alrighty. Now I'm gonna add a new layer. This time, just to save some time, I'm gonna do a whole layer of white. I'm gonna paint bucket. I'm gonna drop the opacity a little bit. Ooh, ooh. And then I'm gonna add a new layer. Go back to my brush. Make sure the hardness is 100%. I'm gonna take the opacity up to 100%. I'm gonna switch to black. And now we do the black and white line art. Which, hang on a second. Let me just think, okay. This canvas is 8 inches. I want this kid to be 8 inches. So I almost just made a terrible mistake and made him like, what is he, 4, 3 inches? We don't want to do that. I'm gonna merge these. Command T to turn it into a bounding box tool, and then let's grow this kid because we want him to be nice and big. Let's just lock these ones because I have a really bad habit of accidentally choosing the wrong layer and drawing on it. Oh my God. This is probably my least favorite part of the whole process. I like the sketching. Oh my God. Oh, no. Nope. 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 I think the top part actually looks a little tall for the bottom part. I will say that. So maybe we should scooch it down a little. Oh man, this might be a bad idea. Ready? Control T. Zoom in here. And I'm just gonna slide her down. Ooh, this is actually going out pretty well. Alright, so now that that is done, I can hide that layer. I'm going to change the background color to something obnoxious so that I can see what I'm coloring. And then I'm gonna add a new layer. This layer is for the color, and now we can color him. And if you're wondering how I'm changing between the sizes of the brushes, it's the right and left bracket keys. Left and right. I'm gonna make his hair, how about this in between peanut butter color? I think I'm gonna give him some brown pants, I've decided. Some chocolate pants. Those are a little too murky though. Let's warm it up a little bit. And then for my final touch, I'm going to grab a pink, drop the hardness down to 0. I'm gonna hit the number 2 to change the opacity to 20%. And then let's give this kid some blush. Whoa, that is the wrong color. And then we shall erase the rest of it, so it's not going into his eye sockets. Let's export this. So basically what you want is the highest res PNG that you can make. So I'm just gonna say save as. I'm gonna go down to PNG. Let's call him boy with laptop. No compression, hit okay. Undo this layer of blush that he has. Right click the layer of color, hit blending options, color overlay, and we're gonna go with white. Because we also want black and white line art because teachers really like that. So save as PNG, boy with laptop, BW. Okay, my terms of use is a PDF. It's very simple. It basically just says you can use my clip art in your commercial use stuff, but it can't be sold as individual graphics, and you also can't share it as individual graphics. And also, I added this new note down here that it can't be sold as stickers. I grab a copy of my terms of use. I also grab a copy of my logo, and I hit copy. I'm gonna make a new folder, call it pigknit boy with laptop. And then I'm gonna drag both of my PNG files into that folder. I'm also gonna paste my terms of use and my logo, and now you right click on it, hit compress. You wanna turn it into a zip folder. This is what you're going to upload to Teachers Pay Teachers. I'm gonna bring in the clip art I just made. So the black and white and the color, bring her in, drag it into my preview. Grab them together. Control T to change the size because he's way too big. Oh my God, he's too big. So this picture is, I think it's enormous. So what I'm gonna do is hit image size. It is 8 inches. I'm gonna make it 150 resolution because Teachers Pay Teachers can't support super heavy pictures for their previews. And now we bring it into Teachers Pay Teachers. So, Teachers Pay Teachers. In 100 years, that will open. My product listings, add a digital product. So I realized I forgot that Etsy doesn't allow you to give away free resources, so I can't do Etsy. But if you're interested in seeing an Etsy listing being made for Clipart, let me know in the comment section below. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Okay, so upload product file, you choose your file. This is where you put the zip folder. Ta-da! And then I attest that this is my own work, blah, blah, blah. So you put in your description. This one was part of a freebie collab that I did. I don't know how to figure out Teachers Pay Teachers SEO. I haven't figured it out, so I have no idea. Honestly, I'm just gonna say, boy with laptop, boy with laptop 8, but at the beginning, free. Okay, and then you go down to your resource type. I usually do by TPT sellers for TPT sellers because a lot of my customers are just TPT sellers that are looking to build resources. I say clip art and I like to do fun stuff. Now, this for me is not grade specific because, I don't know, a lot of my stuff I don't think is grade specific. Like this kid, I don't know, he looks like he's in middle school, but you can use him for high school. I don't think people would mind. You can use him for elementary school. Now, this is where you choose your subject area. There is one that is products for TPT sellers. I like to do that one, if I can find it. Products for TPT sellers. A lot of times I'll say for all subjects because it could be anything, but let's see if we can find one that's related to computer stuff. Computer science? You can choose up to three. Just try to find ones that are relevant to what you're doing. So that's about as close as I can get, I think. They added this new thing where you add the number of pages. I don't know, I just put in not applicable. Then you have your categories that you can make, basically folders for people to find your stuff easier. So I have freebies, and you can also put it in more than one, so I'll put it in people. Paid, switch it to free. If you were paid, you would have the price paid right here. If you do a bundle, you can add a discount price, and they have a price where if someone wanted to buy more than one of your clip art, that is where this price would come in. They usually put one in you here for you, and I just leave that alone. Upload your picture, that is where you put your preview. You can put multiples if you want. When that's done, in a few seconds, submit. Okay. So that is basically start to finish, sketch to listing on Teachers Pay Teachers, how you list clip art. I saw a lot of people that actually requested clip art videos, which was surprising to me. I'm shocked, honestly. So if you have any questions or if you have any ideas for future clip art videos for what you would like to see, please let me know in the comment section below. I'm happy to help you for as much as I know, which is not very much, but I'm happy to show you what I know. But thanks so much for watching. If you guys like this video, let me know by giving it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you want to see more, and I'll see you guys next week.